rabbis schooling people on the court. The truth is, this is one of my childhood hobbies. Growing up in Israel, I was into basketball. When I was 12, I came to the Bronx. I was at the parks. Sometimes I even skipped school, shockingly. And I actually had a nickname. They called me Air Jew. There was Air Jordan and there was Air Jew. I wasn't such a great basketball player, but it was a little bit of a novelty. Seeing the rabbi, I wasn't a rabbi then, but the Jew boy putting the ball between the legs, doing some fancy stuff in the air. So I got the title Air Jew. But today, I'd like to share with you an insight, something we could glean from the principles of basketball. You know, you gotta learn from everything. Basketball has so much to teach us about life. So here's an idea. I was having a conversation with another player, a great player, professional basketball player, and I said to him, if you have equal talent, you could be a great shooting guard. Swish, straight into the basket, three-pointers, jump shots, last second shot by Michael Jordan in North Carolina. Or you could be a point guard. Great point guard, dribbling up the ball, passing it, faking, doing all the amazing things that a point guard does. What do you think is a better position to be? So, at first glance, yeah, of course it sounds like shot, swish, the three-pointer. That's where all the noise, that's where you see the sweetness. But I said, no. I think the better position, and the much more important position, and more prestigious position, is the point guard. See, you could be great. You could get that shot in. The most amazing shot. But it's still just you. You got the shot in. But you could be a point guard. You know what a point guard is? That's someone who has to look how to bring out the greatness in every single person. A point guard is not just that focused on himself. He's looking and seeing how can I bring out something really amazing in another person. And you know that's what Judaism teaches. Judaism says, you could be great. You could do an amazing deed, an amazing mitzvah, a commandment. And it's beautiful. You could get someone else to do something positive that's so much more meaningful. You know, the sages teach us that we're getting close. We're at the last quarter of history. It's down to the last minute. We need that really good shot at the end. And I'm telling you, the only way to be successful is if we're a team. If the Jewish people get together and decide, you know what? I won't just be that amazing shooter, the dunk at the end. I'm going to look to be a point guard. I'm going to look to make sure that I could see greatness in every other Jew, in every other human being. If we do that, then our Father in heaven, he's going to give us a big high five. And he's going to smile and he's going to say, all right, we're ready to be a team. You're ready to be redeemed. Thanks.